Radio V. Radio in TV.
Radio in TV.
Money.
All right. Ouch. You are in the hen house on T Radio V. Welcome back. I hope everyone had a wonderful weekend. I had a long weekend. God, I love my job. I just walked around everyone telling everybody I'm a radio show host. I'm a radio show host. And I have a VIP wristband. And they let me do everything I wanted to do.
Did they get you anywhere?
I'm here. Yeah, got me everywhere.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're like, oh, what's your radio show? I said, it's the hen house on T Radio V. Oh, I know it. They don't know it. I mean, maybe they do. That would be wonderful. I'm here with Luke Nero. And Aaron Elvis.
Hi.
Hey, Luke, how was your weekend?
I had a very long weekend. I can't feel my legs from the knee down because I was on roller skates for a good 48 hours solid.
Wonderful. So, yeah.
How's your ass?
Fabulous.
Tight.
Mm-hmm.
Taut.
Rock solid, to be precise. See?
You know, I will say this. I am so very happy. I'm so very happy that we have... It's literally not a shameless plug. This is literally happiness. I'm so happy we have Bartend and WeHo as a sponsor, and I'm so happy we have coffee as a sponsor, because yes. Bartend and WeHo gave me somewhere to go. We'll show some images of the fun shit they had later on. It was kind of an exciting little way of doing shots. So that gave me somewhere to go, kind of a safe haven. And coffee is actually, Coffee Reinvented, K-O-F-F-E-E, is actually bringing this show to you today because I'm still struggling.
Aaron and I are downing coffee, right?
Yeah, literally. I started before the show started.
I went out like I thought I was 20 again. Mm. And I'm here on Wednesday at 6 p.m. still feeling like I'm 32.
You didn't get any sleep, I hear.
None. I slept Sunday night.
So what parties did you do? What was your...
Well, I did Thunderground,
uh-huh.
Which was wonderful. Another, it was a safe bay in a stormy environment.
Did you roller skate all
day? I did. I roller skated all the time.
How were you?
I used muscles I forgot I had.
Since last year.
Oh, my God. My ass, my groin, my hamstrings. The sign.
That's our sign.
The sign went roller skating, and it's still exhausted. I was using that bungee cord to hold my shit together.
It's
worn out.
You trying to work off that dad bod that you were... advertising.
I did. I had three tacos.
All the straight
girls
were loving it, though.
They were. They were loving the dad bod. They're like, oh, you're hairy and tattooed with your Leonardo dad bod.
Oh, boy.
I was like, finally not going to the gym is back in style.
Yeah. I've been in style for years.
But no, I went everywhere. I went to Couture, had a party. I went to One Oak.
What's Couture?
Couture is a little club on Cahuenga. Little club. That was fun.
Was that the Lady Bunny thing?
I don't know. I have no idea who it was, really. Okay. I mean, it was one of those kind of like, everyone's going, get an Uber.
How do you not know if it's Lady Bunny?
Well, she wasn't there.
Oh, okay.
But I showed up really late, so she could have been there and gone.
Lady Bunny was in town?
Yeah, she did a party with...
Phyllis Navidad.
Yes. Okay. Ambrosia Salad, James Cerny.
Fine. Wonderful. Got it.
Talk amongst yourselves. I'm going to rehang this. It's driving me nuts.
Yeah.
Okay,
of course. And what did you do, Luke?
I did my Bondi Friday night party at Revolver, which was a huge success. Casey Alva knocked it out of the park.
Always.
And then I was roller skating at the Thunderground outdoor roller rink at the Pride Festival for 2 days straight.
I saw your looks. They were cute.
They were really cute.
Yeah.
Yeah. My little gay midriff.
Yeah. You were a sailor one day.
Mm-hmm. I was all white.
Like you were like the West Coast.
I was trying to cast of relive those virgin days. You know, with that halo above my head that didn't quite work.
Oh, that
and what
poor
did you
thing.
Do?
I kind of did nothing until Sunday.
I'm such a butch queen that is not straight, but it's up.
That's okay. We'll fix it in the break. I kind of stayed away from West Hollywood altogether.
Can I have a lesbian call in and tell me how to fix the sign? We do take call-ins at 855-TRV in L.A., 855-878-4652.
Please,
and if you can't get a single in Los Angeles, you can Skype in.
But Sunday, I spun at Tortilla Republic, which was awesome. It was really, really fun. I was there with my old, my ex DJ twin, conjoined twin, since they split
Aaron
us up.
Elvis.
Yes.
Aaron Colbert.
Aaron Colbert, yeah. Okay. So Aaron and Aaron were back for one night only.
Ab. One night only. But I'm happy for Pride to be ever.
Oh, you and me.
I'm all about celebrating gayness, but Jesus Christ, it kills
you. Yeah, 2 days is more than enough.
I'm always a poo-poo gay before gay pride, and then I'm a FOMO gay about an hour before pride. It's like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
And then you're over it halfway
in. There's nothing to be proud about. I'm not going. It's just foolish and adolescent. And then by like Friday at 9 o'clock, I have that fear of missing out. And I'm like, oh God, what are they doing without me? And then by Saturday afternoon, I'm like, what have I done to myself?
Yeah. Now, was it busy this year? Like, were the numbers higher than it usually is, or was it?
I think they were. Kesha was performing.
It was. Does she really draw that many people?
Yeah.
It was for Kesha.
Because all the kids from out of town, like, we're spoiled bitches because we live and breathe in Los Angeles. But the kids who are, you know, from the suburbs and
I just didn't on think the she other was side that of that, popular.
She still is. Yeah. Well, it's a very she has huge hits. Huge.
It's a very pedestrian.
Huge hits. But still, they're still kind of, you know.
Okay.
Well, it's a pedestrian event. It's very pedestrian.
Yeah.
So you get people from Omaha. Kesha ain't coming to Omaha unless you're buying a $100 ticket for, you know, the Thunder Stadium.
By the way, I saw a clip of Wilson Phillips.
Oh, he was so good.
Yes.
I loved it. I loved it.
Wait a minute. They were horrible.
Yes, but it was so wonderful.
Oh,
it was
God.
The whole nostalgia thing, though.
No, I love that.
People just wanted to hear that. Song.
I just wish they would have rehearsed before they got on stage.
Well, you can't harmonize if all three of you are singing the melody.
Oh.
Everyone's like, hold on for one more day.
Oh.
That's
and that was good comparatively.
That's all people that is all people wanted to hear anyway, was that song.
Oh,
just
duh.
That one duh. And only song.
They kept doing covers.
They did, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I saw that, you know, I saw them sing California Dreamin'. That's why I was like, you know, being children of the mom.
Well, we have a guest on our show today.
We do. Yeah. We do. We have Jonny Drubel on, who is our star reality guest. Sorry for all of those who were tuning in to see Wendy Ho. She's been rescheduled.
She'll be back on the 15th.
Bitch getting paid. She's called a gig. But Jonny Drubel's going to be here. He's going to talk tea and shade and celebrity gossip, honey.
Good.
I live for a good dig. I live good. For it. Because it's not rumor. You know, he's a reality TV star, so this is shit that happens.
Yeah, he's got the tea.
He's on Rich Kids Bevrely Hills on the E! Network, and I'm excited to hear what he has to say. And he's doing something on the show today called periscoping.
What is periscoping?
Well, I thought it was something I did back a couple years ago when I was on too much ketamine. And I thought you just kind of went down and your vision, like, you tunneled. Supposedly, it's a live question thing.
Yeah.
His fans. He's got, like, 148,000 Instagram followers. 148K that are going to ask him questions. We may not get to all 148,000 questions.
I have almost 2,000.
I think I have about 1,300.
I didn't even touch it.
Congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations.
I've got tens of people that follow me on Instagram. All tens of them. It's kind of, but Periscope is kind of like, have you heard of Meerkat?
No.
It's Meerkat is kind of like you are live coming from somewhere. It's basically like you're your own reporter.
Okay.
And you can record things live. So while we were doing not Steel Magnolias, I was backstage and
Men
I was meerkatting.
Steel
so what Magnolias. I did was I was walking around the dressing room and filming everyone. Mm-hmm. And it was live on Twitter. Like you could click on Twitter and see us doing this thing live.
Meerkatting sounds like you're going to take a nervous dump. It sounds like you're turtle heading.
Yeah.
Like a meerkat. Yeah. I'm prairie dogging.
Yeah. But like U2 has done it for every single concert. I guess they're involved with them somehow.
Right.
So from every concert.
So it's a more interactive experience.
Completely, yeah. Okay. And they're saying that and Periscope are kind of like the new wave of the future because it's like you can have your own live TV show.
Right.
And people can watch
I like it.
Yeah, it's kind of cool.
Well, I'm excited.
All right. Well, we're going to send it out to a break here. And when we get back, we're going to have Jonny Drubel. You're listening to The Hen House on T-Radio V, sponsored by Bar 10 and Coffee.
Money. Ain't it strange how we called out your name? I'm in silence again. Can't remember when I let smile with it. Guess too bad, is it? But I'm letting go. I'm giving in. 'Cause I still love you. Please come back to me. I still
All right, you're back in the hen house. Aaron Elvis.
Yeah.
Who are we listening to? I really like that.
That, what, our theme song?
Mm-mm.
Oh, the song before. That was Jennifer Hudson, I Still Love You. It's her gay pride video where she's at a gay wedding.
And what is she going by now? Like J-Hood?
No, she's going, it's kind of when J-Lo became J-Lo, she became J-Hood. She's been that for a bit. She doesn't really go by that. It's just a stupid
nickname.
It's just
so terrible. J-Hood. I don't know. Doesn't have a ring to it.
Speaking of J, let's talk about this gentleman, Jonny Drubel, in the studio.
Okay,
welcome. How are you doing?
Good. We're periscoping right now, too, guys.
Is it killing my ratings?
What? No, we're multimedia right now.
Okay, you should be periscoping and on tradiov.com.
I am on tradiov.com right now.
Perfect.
Front center, baby.
So tell me about this periscoping. What's going on? People are looking at you.
Oh, you saw yourself on camera?
I know, mm-hmm. I know. That always happens.
You got to work at that angle.
Periscoping is basically you can have these, your fans can basically live feed into some kind of video thing, and they're basically watching us live from my iPhone.
Great.
So now we're all reality stars.
And then, I love being a reality star.
Now we're all reality stars. Say hi.
Hi.
Hi, kids.
How good looking are all these guys?
Stars.
So let's talk right away.
Do it.
How did you get on? So it started with like Instagram accounts, the Rich Kids thing, right?
Like started with Rich Kids of Instagram. Dorothy Wang, who is the like a very big member of the cast, and Morgan Stewart were on the blog, and then you know they approached them producers and they said, "Who are your friends? Give us 20 of your friends." And then in the list were obviously me, Roxy, and then Brennan was an obviously go to because he's dating Morgan. And and then obviously EJ joined the cast and he's a great addition. And with EJ came Taylor because they're friends, and that's how the show kind of started.
Because it started with just you guys taking Instagram photos of your ridiculous purchases.
Oh, they're not that ridiculous, are they?
They're justified.
Sure.
It's like, look at my gold-plated Nikes. Look at my Learjet.
If you can afford it, why not? If you can afford it, buy it.
I am with you 110%.
Exactly.
You are affording the things I want, and if I could, swipe, honey.
Yep. Exactly. Swipe.
Beyond.
And you guys just wrapped yesterday, season 3?
Season 3. We just wrapped filming season 3. We're going into episode 4 on Sunday. So episode 3 on, episode 4 on Sunday. I can't keep up.
That's
crazy. Starting to lose track.
What's the craziest thing that has happened while filming a reality television show? Like, it's nuts in life all the time, and I go, God, I wish there was someone filming this.
The craziest thing for us this season was actually the fight between Morgan and Roxy, only because it got very, very heated very quickly, and it's getting a lot worse, and it's very, very real. And people always ask, is your show really real? Yes, this drama this season especially is very, very real. It's very interesting.
It was like a Ron Burgundy moment. It was like, oof, that escalated quickly.
And it's only getting worse.
Wow.
Yeah, only getting worse.
So there's real tension on reality TV. This isn't produced. This is not produced.
You cannot produce this shit.
So this is off-camera, bitch.
But we're not getting Bad Girls Club. No one's getting cut, but it's there's a lot of, it's white girl drama.
You pay someone to
and
cut
it's
a
hard. It's hard to heal and mend that in front of a camera.
Oh yeah, impossible. Yeah. Especially when it comes to boyfriends and all that shit. So it's difficult.
Well, it's hard to take the higher road and be the bigger person on camera because all of a sudden feathers start getting ruffled mm-hmm. and they puff out their chest because America's watching.
Yes, I agree.
That's crazy.
It's difficult.
Do you have any Periscope questions? I'm obsessed with this.
Let me see. They come in quickly. Do you guys have any questions for us? Gay questions. You got to be all,
Okay.
So when do you start season 4? When do you start
We'll
filming?
We have to hear about season 4, but we'll probably start filming. We're averaging like 2 seasons a year as of now, so I would say probably in August we'd probably start filming. Yeah.
I would think with all that tension, they'd want to keep going.
Are you joking? Yeah. Get that shit on camera. Yeah.
Did you film your Gay Pride weekend?
Everyone's saying hi. I did not film Gay Pride weekend. Sorry, I'm schwitzing. I'm Jewish.
It is hot in here.
And I'm gay. And I'm Irish. The gays schwitz a little more. But you're in a sweater.
I'm Irish Catholic. I'm sweating like a whore in church.
Are you really?
You schwitz, I'm a whore in
church. Yeah.
And I got a pound of makeup on, so it was.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, just a pound.
You're not even glossy.
Mm-mm,
she actually takes a baby wipe and removes the slurry.
I've worked it.
The best part about cameras is that you can never tell. Oh my God.
The lighting's really good in here, so it's fun.
Very, very good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. God, I love this.
And your tits look lovely today.
So what'd you do with your gay pride?
Gay pride, I went to this great, great roller rink party. It was very, very fun. I loved it. I had a great time. I saw you two there.
Yeah?
Yeah, that was very fun.
Are you a roller skater?
Did you see me eat shit?
Did you?
I ate shit in my phone.
Oh,
with
you wine. Did?
Because
oh,
I was shit, an embarrassing shit. One trying to take a selfie while skating, oh. And I'm not even joking. I ate shit, and my friend was like, and I was like, Jordan, shut. Can I swear her?
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Jordan, fuck shut cunt. The fuck up. Don't make it a bigger deal than it actually is. And of course, he was just like, oh my God, what the fuck did you? Flying. I got to have a movie. And my phone, I was in the middle of the ring, my phone hit the other side of the wall.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so that was interesting.
I actually have a video here that I'm going to forward to Jake and we'll post. It's you trying to take a selfie.
Perfect. Oh. Done.
Was that mid-fly? Mid.
Oh, my God. Everyone's saying, thank God I didn't crack your screen, Jonny. How would you take selfies? Oh, my God. I love
wow.
It. Oh, God. I love I want you to be in front of this. It's actually really funny. Because you can really? Start into questions. And a lot of them are, some of them are kind of mean.
Really?
Yeah.
Mean girl questions?
Oh, I want to hear the mean questions.
I can respond
oh, good. See, because when you're on a reality show, you start to realize what your flaws are. Uh-huh. You know, and what you don't think they are. And I guess I have very big ears. And someone wrote in, thank God you have ear things on because they're covering your ears.
Oh,
wow. That was nasty. Thank cunt. You guys. Nasty. So sweet.
Anonymous
cunts. A bunch of
people love to be nasty.
People just love to be nasty.
Behind the screen, yeah.
How could you guys? You guys aren't nasty. Though.
I can handle a good mango.
All right, let's speak about
oh,
yes. Nasty.
Hell yes.
I know you have an obsession, so let's get nasty with your obsession. Katie versus Taylor.
Oh, okay. I don't understand how anyone could not be Team Taylor.
I
cricket, cricket, cricket.
I don't know enough. I just
I'm
know Katie.
Not Team Taylor.
You're Team Katie?
Yeah.
Okay, tell me why.
Because I can't stand Taylor.
I love Taylor Swift
I find,
so much.
I, you know what? I find not 1 ounce of genuineness in her in any way, shape, or
I'm
form.
I'm Team Katie because I think it's all, Taylor's
you know who she
everyone.
Is? You know who she is to me?
Right.
She is.
She's a good lineup.
She is Violet, a.k.a. Fern Mayo from Jawbreaker. She's like the ugly girl that they made pretty, and she's suddenly cool and what have you.
But can I but say is one no. This? Yeah. One thing, she is a genuinely good songwriter. If you look at the credits on her album, mm-hmm.
Well, we're not denying that she's a smart girl.
So then what is it again? Yeah. Why is it Team Katie? Why is it Team... Then what are we? What's the risk?
Where did it start? I don't even know where
I
it started.
I kind of know why. I heard, this. Don't quote me on this and hold me like you know to it, is that Katie had backup dancers for her
right.
tour,
right.
and
correct.
Then Taylor borrowed them for a certain amount of time for some
she didn't
show.
Borrow them;
she
stole
them.
Them.
Yeah, but you know what? Okay. And I'm gonna
there's
be honest.
A difference.
I'm gonna be honest. Katie tweeted some not nice things about her show. Not nice things about her show.
About so this
a,
show?
About no Rich Kids.
Oh, she doesn't know.
Oh, she
kids.
About
did?
Your show?
Why?
Really?
Yeah. First,
so that's
and we got
why you're
we got
Team
we got
Taylor.
Emails from RPR. She was like, "If you have any sense, don't ever watch Rich Kids of Beverly Hills." And I was just
wow.
like. We've been on the air for a half hour. Like it was the first episode. I'm like, give us a minute, Katie.
What did she find that and was nonsensical?
Yeah. I mean, it was nonsensical. If you had any kind of brain, whatever, if you wanted, it was something really not very nice. And I was just like, all right, Katie, that's fine. Because I loved her. I was
doesn't
a massive
seem
fan.
Very objective.
But I still like Taylor Swift a lot. Just I think her music's amazing. And I think she's so sweet. And have you seen her friend group? I want to be part of that group.
Who, Taylor's?
The Gigi Hadid group.
Oh, yeah, they're amazing.
They are mm-hmm. so hot. It's unbelievable.
What is Gigi Hadid? Let's step back here. What is? What, I don't know what that Johnny's means.
Face right now.
She is.
He doesn't know who Gigi Hadid is.
Is don't that
what
like,
it
how do you not?
No, me.
Gigi Hadid, she's probably the
she's
biggest.
The daughter of Yolanda from Real Housewives of Beverly Hills.
Oh, okay. That makes
fucking
sense.
Gorgeous.
Yolanda's daughter.
She's,
the new,
she's
beyond gorgeous.
She's actually the new generation of supermodel. Like,
yeah.
she's just hit the floor
yeah,
running.
She just moved to New York. Yolanda cried for a whole episode.
Yes.
And then her Lyme disease kicked in
correct.
And she had a nap.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. And like every second billboard on Sunset Boulevard has
it's insane.
Gigi on it. Yeah.
Sunset Plaza.
Yeah.
Gigi.
Yep. It's amazing.
It just sounded like Gigi Hadid to me just sounded like a group of bougie Persians.
Well,
like they're the Gigi Hadids.
Well, yeah. Well, no, her dad is. I think her dad is Middle Eastern. I don't know where he's from though.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think he's Persian. I want to say he's Persian.
Did you do anything?
He has more
crazy
money than God
for Pride. Was there anything
are
you're like?
It
oh,
PG? Or are we keeping it rated?
No.
X?
This is your
no.
image, honey. You do whatever
no.
you want.
You're
alive. There's no PG on this show.
Crazy for Pride. All right, I'm gonna air some dirty laundry. I took Pride a little hard night
that
one. I'm
girl.
The kind of person that just kind of goes in full force. And I ended up going to Greystone Friday night and drank way too much to the point where I was not doing hot later that night by myself. And mm-hmm. I passed out next to the toilet.
Wow.
Yeah. 3 a.m. Totally naked. It was fantastic. Woke up. My stomach had never looked better.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went out and just did it all over.
I always recommend throwing it up before you go to bed.
Yeah. Oh, there it is, Luke.
No,
that's why I love you.
Yeah.
Working out, Karen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And everyone's had those nights, let's be honest. Everyone's had those nights.
Did you go to bar 10 and suck on an icy dick?
I did. No.
Jake got the pictures. Okay. Jake, can we, look, there it is.
What so is that?
They got a 40-pound cock luge.
That's my neighbor, by the way. How
they got a cock luge.
Oh.
And you pour the liquor in the top, and it chills it, and you suck it out the tip.
That is a fat fucking dick.
That's a fat, icy dick. Look, there he is. He can almost get it all in his mouth.
Now, I know. I have a question with
Rainbow
that
Mohawk. Rainbow Mohawk to me spells I can detach my lower jaw.
Wow.
Now, would that hurt going down?
No, it's numb.
The ice would numb.
Yeah,
right?
It's numbing.
Does it ever hurt going down?
Yes, honey.
Johnny, sometimes. What's the difference between jam and jelly?
I have no fucking idea.
I can't jelly my dick down your throat.
Oh, wow. Jesus Christ.
No, it's
I'm going to take that one. I'm going to take that one.
Mm-hmm. Take that icy dick. So. You didn't really do anything terribly crazy. You just ended up messy.
I didn't know. I'm actually, I'm pretty.
You didn't wake up in the morning and like face palm.
You
like,
got a little color there.
Well, I'm burned to crisp.
I'm red like a tomato
as
well.
Yeah.
I look like a leather handbag underneath all this makeup.
103 inches of makeup.
Thank you.
I liked your tan.
Louis Vuitton.
You guys were out there forever. It was great.
Yeah.
And what'd you do Saturday?
Saturday, I went to, I did a lot of parties this weekend. So I went to the Mondrian party for a second. I went to Soho House, which was fantastic. I loved that party. I went to Thunderground, which is, I love, by the way, Hard Turner to Disco. I went to go see a show, I came back, and it was a full-on fucking disco.
Right.
And I was skating around in a disco.
It's a great installation.
It's
really
a
is.
Great installation. It's a great, honestly, it was probably the most fun that we had. And you know, it was like a little Coachella.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun. The music was great this year. I thought the music was
music
wonderful.
Was fantastic.
It's always fun. Luke was in a little sailor's outfit.
I love the little sailor's outfit.
Yes, I did.
It was fun. It was really fun.
So now I want to jump back to you personally and Rich Kids and whatnot, because I was reading, you are a staunch supporter, that you guys are no longer supported by your parents, that you're all very hard workers, that yes, you may have started with a little easier track, but like, for instance, you're always quoted in interviews, like, I work, your mother gave you your ideal of work, like constantly work. I believe it was the more you put in the top of the funnel, the more comes out of the bottom of the funnel.
Always.
You're always
concentrating. Oh my God, I love how you do your research.
Putting more in the top of the funnel.
Yes.
So are most of you real estate agents? Or most of you, where do you find yourselves working? I know one's a blogger. And one sold his first house at 18.
Yeah, that's Brendan. Brendan did not go to college. He decided to skip college and get his real estate license. And he sold his first house at 18. I want to say it was like $25 million or something, or $18 million like that. I can't say that everyone is self-sufficient, but I personally can say that I've been self-sufficient financially since I was 21, 23.
Now, is that songwriting, like they're being purchased?
No, I work for a marketing firm.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I work for a marketing firm out of New York. I'm their content manager, so I've been doing that. That's kind of like my 9-to-5 thing, and then I film when I can, and I have my hands in a lot of different baskets right now, and hopefully one picks up, and... Mm-hmm. You go from there. But songwriting's been great. I haven't been able to do it for a minute just because I haven't had the time.
Yeah.
But I did have a song get picked up. Nelly's on it. He's on the track, which is fantastic. So that's kind of cool.
Is that the big announcement you were talking about last October?
No, the big oh my God. What was I talking
about? I do my research. I dig. There was something big.
In music?
In music that you couldn't talk about yet, but there was an announcement coming.
That? I know what you're talking about. I still can't talk about it, because here's the deal. When it comes to music, they're like, oh, it'll be announced then, it'll be announced then. They push it back.
It's always pipelined,
But this is kind of, this one's much bigger than that. Nelly's fantastic. He's actually great. I've met him a couple of times. He was very, very sweet to work with. But this person's massive.
That's awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
I have to throw a compliment here. I've been out to dinner with Jonny, and he will be stopped every 2 seconds down the street at the dinner table to say hi or take a picture, and he says hi and takes a picture every single professional time with a smile, and that is exhausting to watch, but it's amazing that you do that for all your fans.
Thank you very much. I love my fans.
That's really great.
I always put it, when I was younger, I would always think, oh my God, what if I can meet this person? What would it like being? And so I put myself in their shoes, and I'm like, fuck it. Like, you know, I can make
hopefully
that person.
Hopefully they're kind. Yeah.
I can make that person happy. Yeah, like, I love doing that.
Yeah, even people like screaming out of cars, like you will wave and say hi, and just, it's amazing. Yeah.
That's
oh my God,
really
the best
great.
Thing, I was talking to like an ex of mine at the Abbey, and I was bawling, crying. I was full on fucking, we've all been there.
No,
fuck
somebody
off.
Came
everyone
up
here
course,
has been there. Everyone here has cried at the Abbey.
Oh, Aaron knows.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, he's like, yeah, it happened
times.
Over pride.
I'm missing the front half of a truck because of an ex. And
no,
Jameson.
I was crying. I was talking to him. I was crying. And this guy came up to me and was like, hi, I love you. And I was just like, how are you? And I was just like, tears are gone. He was like, oh my God, good to see you. And I was getting a picture of him. He watched me. I was like, oh my God.
Luke just at his party. So he'll be giving, you know, angry face. And he just.
Oh, yeah, Luke. Oh, my God. Don't you love that? Yeah, from Luke's. Hello.
He does?
Darling.
Aaron just gets the honest face. Well, I'm going to hand it over to Aaron. I want him to talk about the track. We're going to head to another break. Aaron, what are we about to hear? Because you always bring us some sort of fun, loving music.
We are about to hear. Of course, I don't have it open up. Oh, my God.
That's all right.
Let Nana put her glasses on.
Nana's got to get her goggles on.
It's a remake of Club Lonely with Michael Salomon and Majuri.
All right. Well, we're going to send it out to a remake. And Aaron's always got something good for us. We'll be right back in just a couple of minutes here in the Hen House.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
On the list.
What list?
The DJ's list.
Miss Thing, there is no guest list tonight.
Oh.
Come on.
Alrighty, you're back in the Hen House with Aaron Elvis, Luke Nero, Jonny Drubel, and I am Adam Klesh. I want to remind everybody that you can call in at 855-TRV-NLA, and you can also Skype at T-Radio-V-LA. I also want to talk about our sponsors, Coffee Reinvented. It is the low-acid, stomach-friendly, cold-brewed, alkalitic water, dairy-free, vegan, organic, fair trade coffee bean, gluten-free, soy-free, nut-free.
Damn, G.
Atta girl.
Damn.
That was great.
And Bartend WeHo, which you can find at www.bartendweho.com. A great little place in West Hollywood. Has a pool table, some great cocktail lists, and a lot of really good munchies for not that much money. Rather inexpensive. I don't want to say cheap. So we're going to jump right into it now that we're back. I've got to talk about Rachel Dolezal. This bitch.
She is this week's this
bitch.
Yeah,
she is this week's this bitch.
I mean, I was actually going to nominate her as my...
Exactly. We'll get to that segment for those of you waiting for it, but she's the grand this bitch. Oh, we got some photos
this
up.
This is her as what?
This is black.
Yeah.
She went through like reverse... Totally black. She went through reverse Michael Jackson. She did the reverse.
Well, she's relating herself to Caitlyn Jenner now.
Which is so offensive.
It
really is.
She's putting her in the same... Yes.
I can understand the psychotic reasoning, but I can't get behind it. I mean...
Look at her.
I mean, she looks like a light-skinned sister.
Was that when she was a flight attendant?
I can't understand that reasoning. I've talked to my parents about this, like, genuinely, on the way here. They're like, well, maybe isn't that kind of the same thing as Caitlyn Jenner? I was like, again, I understand growing up at 5 or 6 or 7, questioning your sexual identity, like, you know, like, wanting to try your parents' shoes or whatever, but... I've never heard of, and this might be a new thing, someone being like, oh, maybe I'm supposed to be a different race. I don't get that, personally.
Well, for those of you that don't understand or know who she is, don't close the browser on the Hen House and don't Google. I will tell you. She was a Caucasian woman born of Caucasian parents. Her father's German. Her mother's a simple European mix. She got into African studies and all this stuff and... married a black man with 4 black children. She graduated, went to a master's program of African studies. When she applied for college, she put Caucasian on the application. When she applied for her job at the NAACP in Washington, she checked the black box.
Right.
Or African-American box. I haven't seen the application. I'm not sure. Got the job and estranged herself immediately from her family and for almost a decade. And then her parents came out in an article saying that she estranged herself, and they are both white. She is absolutely white and living a lie as an African-American woman.
Huge lie.
Yeah. Now, the NAACP came out.
Well, she didn't, when someone would mention her background, she didn't correct them. She just went along with the assumption that she was black for the longest part. So she was just, and she just got darker
and darker. When she was presenting herself as a black woman.
Yeah, she just never corrected herself. Yeah. Right. Ever. So.
Well, and the NAACP said she should have been honest all the time. Her work is wonderful.
Yeah.
We love her. Yeah. And it actually may have meant more.
Had nothing to do with her work.
And a white woman fighting for us.
Right.
Yeah.
Did she get fired after this whole thing or no?
She resigned.
So she got fired.
Because the NAACP, NAACP can't honestly come out and fire her because that would look terrible.
You
but
can't.
They can be like...
Do you think here's my question. Do you guys think that she was wrong for doing what she did?
Yes. I do, personally. Because we're not talking about a singular event. We're talking about, I mean, now all the stories are really coming out. It's like we talked about on our first show. We only get sound bites that the media wants us to see to sway an opinion. And if you dig deeper, I love doing my research, like she called for a boycott of the movie Exodus because they used white actors of a primarily black region at the time. Like she went and did these things that were not only pro-African-American or pro-black, however you want to identify, but were anti-Caucasian.
Right.
That, I mean, it just tells a whole story being spun there.
She's also fighting for people who are treated differently, treated badly for being black, and she pretended she was black, and at the end of the day, she's still white. She could, you know, catch a cab anytime she wanted
to. Wasn't there a movie in the 80s about this? Didn't a guy put on blackface and go to college?
Soul Man with C. Thomas Howell, yeah.
He wasn't around.
It didn't end well for him either, but he got to go.
Shut your mouth.
She's like anything pre-90 I wasn't there for.
Like, looking black is one thing. It's fine. You know what I mean? Like, dreadlocks, fine. Like, she's darker, fine. But, yeah, calling yourself black is a completely different...
Yeah, like living your life
like
as a black
Beyonce,
person.
She white.
Yeah.
But no one complains about that. But she doesn't call herself white.
And she got white woman problems.
Yeah. She got white woman hair.
Yeah.
You guys are all going to hate me. I sympathize with her.
I don't really hate you for that, but explain.
I sympathize with her because bottom line is this.
I think you lost 44,000 followers.
There it is. And the cameras go black.
You just canceled.
I know, right? Here's the reason I sympathize with her. I think that as a gay guy, I don't want someone else telling me how to live my life. And I don't want someone telling me how I... Is
Soul Man.
Yeah, there
was,
she
I was
is.
Like, is that her?
She's a Hollywood star.
She does look black. No, but I
love Jake.
I felt bad for him because I don't want something. It's not my business. You know what I mean? Right. If she wants to identify as black, that is fine. Here's where she went wrong. I read in the New York Times today that she sued Howard, which is a predominantly African American school. She went there as a white person. You know what I mean? And she sued them for not giving out enough scholarships to white students.
Mm-hmm.
So she's playing both cards.
Correct.
You know what I mean? Yeah. You don't have some kind of weird revelation. That to me is when I kind of, and I actually found that on the way here, I was talking to my dad about it. And I didn't like that. I thought that's bullshit. So there goes her whole entire, like, I'm trying to be me thing. That's bullshit.
It just doesn't fly for me.
She's just doing what suits her at any given time.
I sympathized with her until I heard that. I was just like, all right, well, she's just dumb.
I was so jaw-dropped when I read it. Like, you know, just poking around on the internet, and this was everywhere, and I was like, who is this black bitch that they're talking about? And I pull it up, and I'm like, what? Now, there were some very funny things, I will say. I won't repeat many of them, but you can find them on Facebook, and they were talking about the spray tans and little slogans for tanning salons that they could use.
So many good memes out there, too.
She's tan mom, I guess.
Well, there's this, like...
She's tan mom.
There's an ebony cover of the play on Caitlyn from Vanity Fair or whatever, and it's her. I don't know what the wording is, but I'm sure we could find it. And it's like, am I black? Or, like, call me Caitlyn, and she goes, call me black.
Oh, no! That's amazing.
Well, there's a before and after that uses tan mom and Medea, and I was dying. And it said, look what, it's something about like what you can do with an edumacation. And I was on the floor.
That's bad.
The memes are great, though.
Well, I'm sure it'll be going on until it's been, you know, completely juiced, and then we forget about it, and she'll be fine, and she'll move to Hawaii or something, or some, you know, American Samoa, and then she'll be Samoan, and it's fine.
But it's also bringing up the word trans for everything now, which is pissing me off.
Mm-hmm.
Let trans have the word trans. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's
this is not.
She's transracial. Racial.
No,
is what she's
exactly.
Saying.
She's like, what are they called?
Transracial.
But if she wants to be considered transracial, if she wants to be considered black, I have no problem with her being. If she wants to be considered black, she should be able to consider black. That's it. If that's how she wants to be. But then I saw actually Whoopi Goldberg today on The View. She was saying, then you know what? As a black woman, you have to understand that they have it a lot harder.
Yeah, that was my point before.
For real.
You know what I mean?
Because at the end of the day, she's still white.
Correct.
Yeah, you need to really know. Because, I mean, let's just be honest. It's unfortunate. It's just of what's going on in this country. But that's just the way it is. And I think Whoopi Goldberg made a good point. Right? Whoopi's like, I don't give a shit if she wants to be black. Be black. Yeah. And I was like, I agree. It's not my business.
I think she's having a hard time because everyone's probably nipping at her heels.
Oh,
but I don't think she had the hard time of a black woman like... You know, the story of coming out of the inner city, fighting for an education, but she sounded like it was a pretty easy
route.
Well,
she's number one news story
she's
on
trending,
every channel.
Honey, she's
so
trending.
Does she have a trending hashtag?
She must.
Oh, she's gone.
Which is it?
Yeah, I know.
White so black speaking lady? Of jaw-dropping, should we talk about Jurassic Park and its biggest opening box office?
Yeah, I think Jake dropped his jaw on what he spent for it. Jake was
Jurassic
not a
World. Sorry, let me
Jurassic World.
Jake wants his money back.
Well, you guys saw it. Nick and I were on our way to see it last night, and then we realized that I was still completely deflated from Gay Pride. I hadn't eaten yet, and that we hadn't watched Game of Thrones. So we stayed in the house. I made dinner, and we watched Game of Thrones. So what did you think of Jurassic World, Aaron Elvis?
I liked it a hell of a lot.
Oh, you did.
It was really really fun. I mean, the story is like, who cares? Mm-hmm. It's the same story you see all the time. However, special effects and everything else, it's beyond fun.
And that bitch was wearing heels the entire
heels. Running
time.
In heels. Not even cute heels, by the way. A nude heel is never cute.
I haven't seen it.
A character shoe?
Almost a character shoe.
I heard they were at the theme park. I saw this on Twitter or something like that. And I guess there's one man they highlight, and he sees the dinosaur coming, and he grabs a margarita and runs.
Two margaritas.
That would be me.
Do you know who he is?
That would too.
Jimmy Buffett. The man who's famous for singing Margaritaville.
That is awesome.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Oh my God, I had no idea.
Yeah.
That would 100% be me.
Yeah.
It's
kind of genius.
Running away from pterodactyls.
Yeah, I know.
Luke and I were discussing how much product placement there was in the movie. It was insane.
Pepsi?
No, not Pepsi. This one was
Mercedes-Benz,
Starbucks.
Yes.
Starbucks
Converse,
was everywhere.
Everything.
Even IMAX was highlighted in it. What else was there?
What would they mean? It was a $200 million budget? Something astronomic?
I'm sure it was big. I couldn't
remember
that
they made
big
like $500 million back.
Yeah.
So much CGI. Oh, yeah.
And
so much CGI.
In gross or net?
As the French say, I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not going that deep. I don't really know. But they made a lot of money. They made
a lot of coin.
Well, that product
and that was here and overseas all combined.
Yeah. Absolutely, yeah.
But that's just the first weekend. That's crazy.
Did we all see Game of Thrones? I know, Luke, you don't watch.
No, I didn't watch that.
You don't watch it either?
I don't watch
but
it.
I did start watching Frankie and Grace, or Grace and Frankie.
Oh, it's so good.
It's so...
Don't watch that either.
I got to the...
Good!
I got to the Yam Lube episode. I'm on Yam Lube.
That's it?
That's it. It's episode 9. Oh, what do you mean that's it?
So much fun.
I watch Yam Lube like a day.
She's like, and it's
that's
edible.
That's why I do at work.
Jane Fonda,
TV
Lily Tomlin, so good. flawlessly
I should start
magical.
Watching.
Oh, magical
on
screen.
I'm going to start watching.
No, they are.
Oh, I love when that happens.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good.
Because it's a gay undercurrent through the entire series. It's so good.
That's yeah.
So you can relate to all of it. You
that's
know what
fine.
I mean? Yeah.
All right, well, spoiler alert. I want to talk about Game of Thrones. There's no snowmen left.
No, there's not.
Every single
not
male
show.
Snow is dead, except...
Well, no,
oh,
only,
no,
no, no, no. There's only one snow.
There's at the tree. Sorry, I mean Stark.
Stark.
From the Stark family. The boys at the tree.
Do you watch Game of Thrones?
I do not.
Neither do I. So.
Oh, they stabbed him in the gut.
So anyway,
like
yes, it was amazing.
Just pretend like I'm talking
about
sports.
I'm a reality TV person. I'm a yeah, reality TV person.
Do you only watch reality TV?
I watch some scripted, and when I do watch scripted, I'm into scripted. Like, I love Orange is the New Black.
Okay.
I love Scandal.
Okay.
I love, oh my God, I'm obsessed with Broad City. On
okay,
Comedy
Beyond.
Central. Love
they're genius.
Broad City. I
yes,
love,
queen.
Obviously, Yes, Queen.
What's your favorite, what's your other favorite reality TV show?
My other favorite reality are Real Housewives.
Which one?
My favorite franchise is 100% New York.
Melbourne.
Really? I love Melbourne.
I love Melbourne too.
Oh my God, it's so good.
I thought it was going to be hard to watch, and it was a little cringeworthy. Mm-hmm. And then it just became
genius.
Delicious
oh, yeah.
television.
It should be cringeworthy.
All reality television should be cringeworthy, including our show.
Some of them are starting to get a little non-cringeworthy. Like
mm-hmm. right.
Beverly Hills is like.
I had to stop watching Mob Wives because it was cringeworthy but predictable.
Oh, no,
you saw it coming.
I can't stop watching
that.
Oh,
I don't watch that.
All right, we are going out for our last and final break. I hope you enjoy the chicken song. And we're going to come back and give you some This Bitch and some Shameless Butt Plugs. You're in the Hen House. Jonny Drubel, our guest. Aaron Elvis, Luke Nero. I'm
hi, hi, hi.
Are back in the Hen House. That is Adam Klesh's new single, The Chicken Song.
You
out on iTunes. Now. That's the remix, isn't it?
It is the remix.
Yeah.
Really, you know, really I got well the biggest issue getting the licensing rights from Piggy and Kermit. It was just a fucking cunt.
Did you?
Well, they said over Gonzo's dead body.
TikTok.
Wow.
TikTok.
All right. Well, it is time for this week's This Bitch. Mine happened at Thunderground.
Was it me?
No, it wasn't you. There were bitches roller skating everywhere, busting ass, falling down, all that other stuff. And then there's like a roller skating referee or professional. He's a tall, muscular, yet slender black man. And he wears like these little yellow booty shorts. So as these bitches are drunk tumbling everywhere, this motherfucker's doing the splits backwards.
Oh, I saw
skating
him.
Skating in between mm-hmm. them, falling, like getting up, doing a backflip. And I'm like, bam, into the side guard wall. And I'm like, this bitch. That was my this bitch.
I never have a this bitch.
I have
because
one.
I think I am this bitch.
Yeah, you are.
I have one. So I'm DJing this private party, this guy's birthday party. And I'm in the bathroom, and it's at the front of his house. Hi, it's at the front of his house, and I can hear this woman going, "I'm at the worst fucking party. The food is horrible. The people are fucking hideous. I'm sitting in the corner, texting people." So I'm like, "I got to see what this bitch looks like." So I look out. She's this giant, overweight blonde woman, who somebody came up to her and was like, "Who are you talking to?" She's like, "Leave me alone. I'm an actress." She was an actress, apparently. And I thought to myself, "This fucking bitch." Like it was. P.S. The party was beautiful. There
and
were really good-looking people
like
there, and she's bored out of her
escape.
Mind. Oh yeah, she's out of her mind bored. loud, like anybody could fucking hear. I was like, this fucking bitch needs to shut her mouth. But I kind of loved her for that.
That's funny. I like that.
What's your this bitch, John?
I'm going to say my this bitch is Hillary Duff with her new single. It's good.
I'm that
good.
Heard.
And when you listen to it, you're going to say, this bitch.
You're like, this? Boy.
Yeah, and that's you're like, one. Okay, this bitch, repeat.
She's got you turned.
Yeah, so yeah, she gets me turned.
Turned.
I like Hillary Duff. She's coming back.
It is
it's
good.
A really
for
good
a pop song.
Song.
It's a very good song.
Very good song.
Yeah.
Well, I like to throw it. Oh, do you have one?
No, but Janet Jackson, honey.
Oh, yeah. This bitch.
This bitch for teasing us like this.
This bitch.
She's like wondering if your cake's done in the oven. You keep peeking. Right?
And I heard a little snippet of her, one of her singles.
It was like the beginning of her album.
Yes, and it is Janet Jackson to the bone, honey.
Yeah. Good.
You're just, yeah, it's
like
amazing.
From back in the day, Janet, or more of her like?
No, back in the day, like,
there's, good.
You know, there's a Jackson coming to town.
Like
yeah. Fabulous.
There's
yeah.
rumor that Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis worked on it with her, so it's like yeah. old,
yes.
old school
yes.
stuff.
Good so job, Janet.
Welcome home, Janet. Yeah. Yeah, it'll be amazing.
Well, Jonny, I want to thank you for being on the show this week, and so I want to kick it to you first for a shameless butt plug. What do you want to sell? What do you want
shameless
people to
butt
see?
Shameless butt plug. Find me on Periscope, you guys. I'll be doing a lot of periscoping for my summer travels. I'm going to Mykonos on Friday.
Oh, wonderful.
I'm going to Bermuda with my family in a couple of weeks, and I'm going to Chicago for market days.
Wonderful.
That's what I have planned thus far.
Now, how do they find you on Periscope?
Just literally go to the app. Download the app, Periscope, go in and just type in Jonny Drubel. I will come up and then just Periscope me and you will be able to travel with me like a rich kid.
As I learned this weekend, great. There's no H, two N's,
yes.
and Drubel.
Done.
Luke, you got a shameless butt plug? You want to shove something out there?
No, I'm pretty good. Actually.
No butt plug for you?
No. It's already softened and loose and ready to go.
They know where
Friday
to
night.
Find.
Bam!
You have Friday night.
Oh, I do have Friday yeah. night. Bondi at Revolver every Friday.
It's very fun.
Wonderful.
Cake. Lots of ass cheek.
Yeah, so, I love it.
Yeah.
Aaron Elvis.
I am at Mickey's this evening for Hot Rod. Tomorrow night, I'm at Sink or Swim at Revolver. And this weekend, I'll be celebrating my 39th birthday again.
I love those 39th birthday anniversaries.
Yeah.
I went to Lip Sync, and I absolutely loved it.
It was so fun.
It was wonderful.
Yeah, yeah.
It was
it's a lot of fun. Yeah.
And as always, I'm going to save my butt plug for our wonderful sponsors, Bar10WeHo, www.bar10weho.com, and Coffee Reinvented, coffee with a K, K-O-F-F-E-E. Reinvented.com. That shit had me jazzed. I got Aaron to the Greek last week
yes.
in about 4.5
yeah.
minutes.
Yeah.
That is all the time we have for Aaron Elvis, Luke Nero. Thank you, Jonny Drubel. I'm Adam Klesh.
Thank
the
you,
foxes
Jonny.
Are coming yeah. in. Time to get out of the hen house. I'm going to send it out to the next show, Drum Smack. Don't miss it. Good stuff.
You are watching T-Radio V. Radio in TV.